You are going to see now, it is very interesting, complicated table, because there are lots of words there, but still, try to follow me and to see what is written there, because it's very, very interesting. And this has to do with tonight. Tonight is the festival of the 15th of Av, and according to our rabbis, if Jews will be worthy, the temple will come down from heaven at that time, and they will finish it off. So, very interesting, important day. If one knows about this day, it was a day that the people of the generation, the desert, finished, passed away. Lots of interesting things happened in this day. It is really a very happy day. In fact, it's a day of wedding. People try to make weddings on this day. So, very interesting table that you are going to see about this day. What you see in this table is amazing. The first thing, you have one thing in the Torah, the temple will come down, which is exactly what our rabbi said. The temple will come down from heaven, and Bnei Israel and the children of Israel, Yashlim, will complete it. Amazing, this is what will be. So both will be partners in the building of the temple, God and the Jewish people. Amazingly, Bnei Israel, Yashlim, the children of Israel. So what you see, as we say, the temple will come from heaven, the children of Israel will finish it off. And amazing, it comes here to Jerusalem twice. You have Yerushalayim here, Jerusalem here. Like in the Bible, without you, then you have Yerushalayim here parallel. And we have really heavenly Jerusalem and on earth Jerusalem. And what is so interesting, as we said, that you have your parallel Messiah, because Messiah will come with this together. And then, what also is very important, that you have here the dates. So there are a few dates, and the one date is really Tavshin Ayin Vav 5776. Then you have another one, Tavshin Ayin Chet 5778. And as we said many times, if Jews unfortunately are missing one, there's another one. And there's a third one, which is 781, which is when redemption of the Av, the month of the unleavened bread, Pesach, and Gog, the war of Gog, will be on Sukkot, according to our tradition, also comes here. I mean, all together, a very, very interesting, significant table about hoping that we'll be already on this Tuba Av. The temple will come down, but for this we need Shiva, for this we have to keep the Torah, and therefore definitely, as the situation today is, this is another one really based on the same thing like before. You have Mikdash Yered, temple will come down, and the children of Israel will complete it, and Jerusalem here, and what is also the dates you have here, amazing, you have the date of 778, which is exactly this year for the time of the creation of Adam. We say that Adam is the root, the source of Messiah. Therefore, we have to look on the beginning of the creation of man. So we are now in this year, coming here. Then we have here very interesting that שאלה מאוד חשובה, אקטואלית, מעשית, ממש לעוד יום, מחר בערב ט"ו באב, וחיפשנו אם יש איזה רמז מעניין בטבלאות על ט"ו באב עם משיח, עם השנה, לא יאומן, ממש זה מה שיצא לי כשחיפשתי את המילה המשיח, המשיח ט"ו אב, פעם אחת בתורה משיח ט"ו אב, ולא רק זה, מיד ליד זה מצאתי וראיתי מינימלי A תשע"ט, השנה הזו, יש לציין שמופיע בשילוח הפרדה, לפיד, תשובה, כי נצטרך לחכות. המשיח מופיע פה עם ט"ו אב פעם אחת בתורה. המשיח ט"ו אב פעם אחת, והמשיח זה מינימלי, A תשע"ט, מי שקצת מבין. יודע שזה רחוק מלהיות מקרי, מינימלי פעם אחת בתור המשיח ט"ו אב, ומינימלי תשע"ט, והם ממש קרובים. יחד עם זה, בתוספת יש פה אותו משיח, שזה משיח השם מרמז לבן דוד, שהוא בא אחרי בן יוסף, בן יוסף, ביום שישי אמרנו, השישי זו המידה של יוסף, ככה שממש כל אקטואלית, מאוד חשובה, אקטואלית, אקטואלית.